People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now today I'm going to talk about a topic that, in my opinion, Jamaican culture doesn't highlight enough. Partly because of this stigma and because, you know, again, you don't really get much woke points for talking about things like this. And to bring up that topic, I'm going to use the now infamous Peter King case. Now, before I go any further, let me just state this. The nature of the Peter King case and the things that happen, some of the details can't go up on the platform, yeah? Because I'd have to water it down and talk around certain things so much to the point where it don't even make any sense. And as I said, the main focus of this video is not necessarily about Peter King, but some things that happen or some things that come up in his case and some things that happen in Jamaica far too often. So, the actual Peter King case, that's going to go on my Patreon, because that's where we can all talk like big people. I'm use the words that I really want to use, sight not slow down or nothing like that. So, if you want, you can check that out for Patreon. Link is in the description. Now, Peter King. Who was he? Well, his official title, up to the point where he lost his life, was Chairman of the Trade Board and Special Envoy of Jamaica. He was officially Ambassador Peter King. Doesn't take a genius to figure out that he was a man of means, very well connected. Well, you see, March 20th, 2006, them find him. The office manager for his business, right, Peter King and Associates, couldn't get in touch with him, right? Couldn't get access to the place. So he decides to say, no, something is wrong. So he make a call to the police. You see, Peter King's house and in business place is upon the same piece of land, right, according to what I'm seeing in the papers. It was on Waterloo Road, so you already know, right? That's another middle of quote-unquote uptown. So, after them can't hear from Peter King, him contact the police. Police them manage to gain entry to his home and then find him wrapped up in a sheet. I mean, I'm not even going to try and describe the scene because, as me say, some serious stuff. I'm not even want water down and talk or nothing, right? But shortly after the discovery, as you can imagine, lots of people were caught off guard. Peter King had friends in very, very high places. And as you know, things like that very rarely happen to people like him, meaning in such positions, right? Such powerful individuals. It's very rare that they, when the crime breeze are blow, it's very rare it stop at Fidem doorstep. So, as usual, the tribute started pouring. And those who knew him well, think of your biggest politician friend, them, and your head of this and the leader of that and the chairman of that. Right? They were really the main people who were coming out at first, because the average Jamaican never really knew much about Peter King. Right? But then, shortly after we hear, say, them hold on for somebody. A man by the name of Sheldon Pusey. Was a young youth at the time. Right. Now, this is where things get interesting. You see, Sheldon Pusey was eventually tried and found guilty. But something was stand out to me is that based on how the scene, right, based on what happened to Peter King in terms of the wounds and everything, based on how the scene was described, it was very surprising for you to say the youth got 15 years for manslaughter. I found that interesting. 15, such a gruesome act. 15 years, not for murder, but for manslaughter. Interesting. So then, naturally, people became curious. Man. What actually happened that day? Well, you see, Sheldon Pusey, his argument was that he went to the house to get a job. Right. Because remember who Peter King was. Right. Remember, I said, due to the fact that he's the chairman of the trade board, special envoy of Jamaica, have enough links inside the Ministry of Commerce and everything there, so naturally, he's almost like a gatekeeper then, right, for enough people. If you want, you know, links carry a far away, so if you know that money, you can get to the link here. So apparently, enough people used to go to the property to get job. Remember, the business place and the house, right, where them find him, they find the same piece of land. So Sheldon Pusey's argument was that him go to the place, end up in the house, right, say him hungry, the man give him something to eat, something to drink, and next thing, well, as I said, I can't even go in the details there. But as I was studying the testimony then, in the quote, something stood out to me. It wasn't even the statement from Sheldon Pusey. Because remember, theme argument is him go there for work and the man try to make a move on him and him basically defend himself, and that's how Peter King, you know. And the other argument was that, you know, him and Peter King didn't have something and then something went wrong and that lead to whatever. But it was the testimony of one of Peter King's staff that stand out to me and prompt me to make this video. Because to be honest, the whole Peter King tapes thing, that is, the people said the tape they need for release so we can see them personally. I don't want to see no Sprat Blues. I have no interest in watching no Sprat Blues. And the whole tape thing has become a joke, right? People in entertainment, they used to who they pan this and who they pan that. Right. Matter of fact, I think it was said that they recovered, right? As in the police recovered, the last figure I saw, right, was 460 tapes. 460 tapes. You can Google it for yourself. But the testimony of the staff member, former worker Peter King, I'll put it on your screen right now. The former employee, Mr. Reese, admitted that a lot of boys would come to the property seeking jobs. That was one of the biggest things that they liable Peter King at the time. So enough young youth used to linger the yard, and according to the former employee, all them just did a come for look jobs. Keep that in your mind. That's going to be the main center and focus of this video. Let's move on. As you can see, it said, it was mostly influential people who would come to the property. He told the inquiry that highly respected persons, including doctors and police personnel, would visit Mr. King. Mr. Reese further told him inquiry that Mr. King kept a catalog of photographs of persons who visited his home. He said Mr. King kept scores of pictures of persons on his personal computer. So, that means that people that visit Peter King yard and they might take picture of them, right, on a store. Then when they added to the fact that the security forces found about 460 videotape. What are the chances that everybody would have got this man yard did not see them there on camera? What are the chances? Plus, even the same videotape them. How many high society people or people in general you think of a volunteer to go up on camera with man? Knowing so them likely I live a double life, because publicly them good up, you know, traditional family man. But when night time come, they must spread. How many of these people you think probably just, yeah man, video me? It's very unlikely. Very unlikely. But if Peter King did have them type of videotape there, well, not if, he did have them type of videotape there, that would give him incredible leverage over everybody with they on it. because if you come on TV every day, portraying for be this and portraying for be that, whether you want to be a politician or you want to be a businessman or you whether you want to be an entertainer, and next thing Peter King got have you on tape, you can't give him no talk. Anything him demand from the people him from the tape, the answer will be yes, because they might be afraid for things drop a road. Now, when we first hear about this, I wasn't even surprised. I was wondering if the tapes them really exist, right? Or if I just, you know, Chinese whisper. But the police them acknowledge that the tapes do exist. And if you're wondering what happened to those tapes, well, apparently them still in evidence somewhere, or probably destroyed, but the police did collect them. In my opinion, no, I don't know nothing. Right. This is not no secret information me I give. That's what they tip me off. But in my opinion, them tapes, they highly likely to still exist. Based on who we are here say, who are they upon the tape them? See, the man say I'm most influential people, because all it take would be one person for the strap it a road, and then society turn upside down. All it takes is just one, especially in this day and age, when things can leak so easy. Right, this went down all the way back in 2016. Right. 2006. Them time the internet never saw, you know, and social media never saw, and it never so easy for us to drop on video. No, you can just take your phone and you don't even need a physical tape. Somebody could have put on the tape them, and then use for them phone and video the screen of them watching from, and then put it on the road. It's too easy. So the fact that them they're still there behind, or still undercover, in my opinion, those tapes probably get destroyed long time. Because if something also happen and them tape they go touch the road, a lot of your favorite politicians and entertainers and, you know, traditional family man would have to go running from Jamaica. Not because they have to, but, you know, shame face. But don't think that these things are unusual for Jamaican society. You know? I mean, no, especially if you live off foreign, you hear say Jamaican people get up every day and hunt down sprats. That's not true. That's an old narrative that just lingers around. The reality is, Jamaicans only have a problem with sprats who can't do nothing for them. If a sprat can give them a job, give them some money, give them some hype, bust them music career, launch them over here, so make them famous, you know, give them credibility, right? Give them security in a bad man place, you know, then people have no problem with sprats in Jamaica. Some of the most infamous 87s and 90s they can think of were sprats in them place, and the residents them know and turn a blind eye. Enough 87 used to carry them man on the ends, and other 87 know say other man and go on like say they must see what go on. Now for the Gully Queens them in Jamaica, when they do them interviews with the foreign place them, and they ask them, oh, you end up here, so listen to the stories them tell us that them come from that place, quote unquote bad man place. Right. And 87 turn them out and then run them out of the place. Residents them run them out. They now run out the 87 who are turned the youth them, you know. They might run out the youth them who get turned. But you see, when it's somebody who is in high society in positions of power, well, that carried to a whole different level, because that person have more access to more people. Because the average Jamaican will not come from certain ends and have no reason for going to 87, right? For look nothing, I want a security, I want a protection, I want ratings, whatever the motivation is. If you go get turned out, I'm going to talk about young youths now. But somebody who is the chairman of the trade board, or is your local, I don't know, JP, or your local DSP, or your local head of this, or your local, you know, the people them who are them play the role of the gatekeepers enough things. If you want certain things, you have to go link them and talk to them. When them people start to abuse them power and start introduce them personal life, right, into them business life, and now try use it to capitalize, right, that's when we have a serious problem. Because you see, we can't tell no big man what we go do with them body. And if them go up on them own free will, if we go take things, forget things, well, what can we say? All we can do is say, well, we believe that, we support that, and that is not right, and all them things. But at the end of the day, two big man, right, I make them own personal choice. So if you decide to start and stop, I wouldn't even bother making this video. Which is when I noticed that the former employee mentioned that, because he was basically a defend Peter King, you know. But in the process of defending Peter King against certain allegations, you know, raised my eyebrow, because the part where he mentioned about the facts that yes, he did see enough youth, young youth, go for the property seeking jobs. But then realize that Sheldon Pusey said that's how him get introduced to Peter King. So when it say lot of quote unquote boys, here the first question I have asked, what kind of age you are talking about? Because Jamaican people are talking about big man, they may just say enough man used to come up at the yard. But they specifically mention boys. So how many of those quote unquote boys did get them picture take and end up on some of them video day? See, when a business boy, where you are, where your favorite entertainer, your favorite head of this, and your favorite minister, did upper house lock up with Peter King, I do. But when I want to know, I want to go on for those quote unquote boys, what happened there? Because if these tape have real boys on it, what about little boys? Well, why wasn't there some form of investigation? Even though I'm gone, right, and you can't press no charges against him, you can't nothing, because him don't get what him get already. But what happened to these quote unquote boys? Because this is not about believing or not believing Sheldon Pusey when him say, oh, he must go up there to get work, right, and the man try make him do this and then him, you know, because as I said, the video I'm going to put on Patreon, somebody details them. Even Sheldon Pusey's story now add up. What I said, I not even want to go into that. I focus on the boys part. Right? What happened to those boys? This leads me into the real focus of this video. You see, in Jamaica, we have a serious problem with Pinckney, I get violating. You heard me talk about the little girl in North time. If you were to truly see the real numbers as to how many Jamaican females, when I'm a little girl, people violate them, you'd be so stunned that I lock up a Pinckney in their house and never let them out ever again. Whatever numbers Sisoka and I don't remember the acronym, but you know the protection agency with the Pinckney them, whatever number them have, is nowhere near the real figure. And this is for the girls, you know. Because enough of the cases are simply not reported. They're serious underreporting, because enough time when Pinckney get violated, so anyway, family tell them, say, keep quiet, nobody bring it up, nobody call on a shame upon me. Right. I saw it go. Move on. No fucking girl hear that. But at least people know say that happened, and it happened regular. But one thing you don't really hear anybody talk about is the fact that enough, it happened to enough Jamaican boy Pinckney too. Not just from relatives and people who know them, but in instances like this, where somebody who is in a position of power use money and lure them and then do what they do to them. What you have to remember, you know, is that According to the Jamaican law, Pitney can't consent. So now little boy, no real little boy better about 9 years now, can't give no big man no permission. Right, according to the law itself, to do no kind of act to them. Even if them say out of their mouth, yes, legally they can't give permission. Let's put that out there, in case Simba Simon come try to tell me, say about, suppose, oh, you know, so the 9-year-old never say, that money I can't do it. And now we're not just talking about Peter King, now we're talking in general, we're talking about the fact of them things they are. That's what might say, yeah, but if look a boy, got money out, then he might go know so that I got complete rubbish. He can use that to big man, because if you're a big man, you're going to money out. You say you look work, and you got a man, please. See how look work and end up in a man's room. Unless you end up in there. Because him put something for I'm a matter of fact, no man can invite me and me out for no work. But I go say in case man throw something and food out of it. No man if me try to get a job from somebody, the first time I meet them can't be in them also. Me meet you also. I'm going to ask the man them something. How much time will never the business and I try to get work? And the first time you and the man meet in him house? House? No man can invite me in a house. For no job. When I do in a room. The first time you and the man attack, figure out your work. You in a man room, I'm yard, as big man. Come on, bro, we don't believe you. So, I'm going to talk about them. But look at Pitney. Especially again, depending upon the age, now I got have them sense then. So me, I wonder all around Jamaica, how many youths things like this happen to? Again, there's no way to know the real figure because even the one them reported, again, it's underreported because enough youths now go come forward because not just is it gonna take a lot of courage. A young youth step forward, but then he must go deal with the shame where the community got pushed back on him. The psycho hear about the incident where the little boy, right, the 16-year-old something to a little boy, and the community make fun of him because he lose part-time body. So imagine a little boy who get violated anyway. So enough youth now go come forward. Enough people in Jamaica in positions of power take advantage of the youth them. I often wonder about some of these youths where you see walk up and down on the road of Jamaica. Some of them can't be no more than 178 at night time, that stoplight, a big money. Sometimes I often wonder what happened to them youth there. I wonder if somebody spot them and realize they're out there by themselves. No protection, no guidance. And then lure them with this and that and then take advantage of them. We must understand as a society that those youths are victims too. Don't tell me, say, they did want it. The little picnic can't consent to nothing in Jamaica. Right. And the same way, we serious about it and we don't run no joke at all when it comes on to our little girls. That the same way, we don't run no joke about it when it comes on to our little boys. Because this is enough for the youths them in Jamaica, enough for these young youths in Jamaica. When things like that happen to them, again, no, me attack in general, we're going past the Peter King thing now. But when things like that happen to them, man, when my young youth, man, did carry them over yes, and then they trust the man and respect the man at the van, and the man end up violate them. Enough of them youths, they end up pick up some traits where them never did have. And then behavior get erratic. And some of the first people who spotted, right, are them teachers. Because some of the first place them start get wild is in school. Because the teacher see them on a day-to-day basis. Because oftentimes that sometimes they own a family or a family friend I do it to them, you know. And sometimes the parents them even know about it and turn a blind eye. Come on. We just get warm up now. Enough time the parents them know about it, but because them love the things the bigger smiley I give them, right? The material things, whatever it may be. Them turned a blind eye, just like with the girls, it happened with the little boys too. So sometimes these youths can't even get help at home. They can't even get security at home. And none of these youths not have no father to defend them. Just like how none of these little girls not have a father to defend them. A solid father at that. A father who is worth something. Right? Because the youths I put that in is because enough man love likes too. So if man give them things, then we turn the blind over things and put them fitness. So that's why I make sure I don't have a solid father. It was worth something when no amount of money can make it to him turn a blind eye if you're violating pity them. So now for these boys, them now get a security at home. So some of the first people spotted are them teachers. And teachers know this little youth, I know, so normally he was a good boy. And all of a sudden, he come back and he just change overnight. Sometimes, and just because the pitney inherently bad, especially when them don't have a history of behaving like this, sometimes there's something on to them and them lash out. That is why sometimes it's better. You see, guidance counselors are very important people. Sometimes before we say, alright, this youth just bad. Sometimes before that happened in a school in the early days, it's good for you what happened to them youths. Because sometimes if somebody just sit down and ask them, why you suddenly start behaving like this? You'll be surprised at some of the answers. When you see a little 9, 10, 11 year old just suddenly start going a certain way, my teacher will tell you. Something not going on in the home or in the community. Because this little boy never used to behave so. Him not in the history of behavior, so him not come from the 87 line, him not power with the whole heap of gang, so him so all over the place all of a sudden. Enough little boy are losing them innocence. People in positions of power, I take it from them. So this is something where Jamaica needs to stop. Bury your head in the sun and go like say, nah, it happened. Or it happened once a blue moon, or it happened, it totally happened over here. So, no, it happened everywhere. From the quote unquote bad man place to the quote unquote high society. Everywhere. And Jamaica have a culture where, when certain things come up, people say, nobody talk, man. Because we don't want nobody to know and nobody to know. It's that culture. That culture is one of the reasons why Jamaica can barely make any progress. Imagine a car have a problem. And somebody go tell you, nobody go tell the mechanic, man. We could also be able to the car fix itself. Something can go so. Your pipe a leak. Yo, nobody go call the plumber, man, because we don't want to shame, we don't want anybody to know that the pipe a leak and shame me. Something can go so. And that's how Jamaicans used to treat crime too. Who remember when I used to first, let me look a video there, man. People used to, one of the biggest comments I used to hear is, all they talk about are crime. No, everybody can stop talking about crime. Remember them days, eh? That's Jamaican culture. We are loaded it up for. Make the rest of the world think that Jamaica is a nice place where you know everybody does live in peace and harmony. Shh. That culture is coming directly from our homes and our communities. So enough little girl, enough little boy, certain things happen to them, family jump on them. Shh. This too shall pass, man. Just pray about it. Just pray about it, man. Nobody cause no fuss and cause no scene. Nobody go report and just pray about it. Let me tell you something. Even though you hear me say, no man is supposed to go up in a man yard for doing an interview or for getting a job, that still don't mean say, if a forced thing go on, that still don't make it right. And any man will try use force and jump man back fence. Man end up doing a dovecot. Man have no sympathy for them. Yeah. But if even big man get lured into going to yard for this and for that, all we are gonna expect the little boy to quote unquote have sense. See, people always mention about this topic, you know, and sometimes when we see some of the things that do right, we can't even answer back because we don't know how people respond to such foolishness. People are going to say, even if little boys are up there, them fields. Think about this. You don't know under what circumstances none of these little boys, again, in general, no, all across Jamaica, what it happened to, you don't know the circumstances in which them end up get violated. Man can't hold them down too. If a man can hold on a full grown adult woman, right, and take what he want to take, how hard do you think it's going to be for him hold on a little boy? So people need to cut out this foolishness and stop trying to make it sound like, say, some of them little youth here almost deserve what they didn't get because of them did go there and then they take this. Little Pitney not have sense like that. Again, more than remember Pitney me I talk about. I talk about the man them with love likes and go up there or take things to get things. I talk about Pitney. Pitney not have sense to me there. Pitney can get lured easily. Right. They are not held to the same standards as adults. If big people are get tricked, imagine a little youth. What people are talk about. As I say, in most cases, a whole long business. And even if it's not a whole long business, we could pick Nicky and consent to Jamaica. Even the law said that. So, let's use the Peter King case to bring up this topic. We want to bring up a long time. It's not talked about enough in Jamaica because you know the shh culture. But just like any other issue, we need to take it seriously. Because some of these same youths, when certain things happen to them, and they can't control their emotions afterwards because you know the whole balance and the frequency get thrown off, enough of them they end up even start both gone. When you hear me talk about the conveyor belt, this put no fuel on the conveyor belt too. But I say another day. Anyways, me say, if you want to hear about the actual case, and check it out on Patreon. This video, I don't know what YouTube are going to do with it. If they end up sending me a warning or something like that, then I could probably just remove it and put it on the website, right? If that happen, right? Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Look out for your video on this PIA. You don't know more life. Ultra squad, stay circling. Even vultures have to eat. Bless.